I have a really cool project here that I built back in 2010 for a good friend of mine. She was nice enough to let me borrow it because back then I didn't have the proper equipment to take a video and some really decent pictures, which I'll show later in the video. The reason why I got it back from her is because not only one, did I want to document it properly, but two, I wanted to show you guys some really unique features that are going on here that I think you guys will appreciate and that I wanted to show you so that you can incorporate them into your projects. One of the things is that the top piece here is actually the thickest of all of the material of the frame here. It then steps down to the side pieces, which are the second thickest thickness, and then these pieces here also step down from the sides. So it has a three-tier step there. It also has a really cool Asian feel to it, and then what I did was I created a stencil from a vinyl sticker that I used to put a gel stain on there, put two or three coats, and then let it dry completely in between, and that happens to be her name in Chinese. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the camera off the tripod here and kind of zoom in and show you some of the cool features. There's also some really neat things going on the back side in order to hold these picture frame, the glass in those picture frames. Let me show you. Here's a close-up of the top. There's the name in Chinese. And here's the three-tier step. So you can see the first step there. And then as you come over to the frame, you can see that these other pieces step down from the sides. And then they are all in the same plane. You can see how, with just a few coats of polyurethane, this bird's eye maple just pops. Beautiful piece. I'm sad to give it back, but it's not mine. Let's take a look at the back. So you can see here on the back that I have the glass here on the right side. Sorry for the camera shake. That is just held in by glazing points, which is how they used to hold in glass back in the day. And then it has a standard picture wire and hooks. Nothing too fancy there. And then on each corner I have some felt to protect the wall. And don't forget to sign your work. Now, here's where I think this piece is really set apart from the rest. And that is these little custom dials that I made that hold in the glass and the matting on the back. So all you have to do is just turn that dial, and there's enough friction there that they're not going to go horizontal. And those are just all the way up. Very, very cool feature. Hope you guys use it. If you do, send me an email, send me a link. I'd love to see what you guys come up with. Sometimes we go into these projects with a plan, and we may have built this project before and we may not have. Chances are, if you haven't built this before, there's going to be certain things that you're going to encounter along the way that you haven't necessarily figured out yet. Kind of like the little dials on the back. I wasn't sure how I was going to do that, and I didn't want something commercial. I wanted something unique to this piece only. So when I got to that stage, I didn't have an answer of how I was going to do that. I had to step back from it and think about it. And I tend to get in these spots during my projects, and I'm sure that you guys have all been there as well. But my point is that don't let that stop you from ever building something. Go ahead and start. If you have to stop for a little while, work on something else, come back to it, chances are that you're going to come up with a solution. So regardless, just don't let that prevent you from building stuff. So anyway, I'm glad that you guys came by and watched this video. I hope that you incorporate some of these features into your own projects. Nice little details they add something to it that sets it apart from something that you can go buy from a commercial vendor. That's what custom furniture is all about. So until next time, happy building. Thanks for stopping by.